What's going on, guys? Lego PC back, and we're talking about a RDA today. First off, thank you to all my new subscribers. I hope you guys enjoy. If you don't like my banter, then come for the review. What we got today?
The Veritas clone.
This device was purchased on eBay. I believe we got it for $15.99. Planet of the Vapes, as usual, I believe. Don't quote me on it. Could have been Vantasia. Anyways, what makes this guy different from every other dripper that's out there? Let's show you. So what we've got here is a vertical coil setup. What makes this guy really cool is, do you see this giant air hole right here? Get some focus there. It's right behind the coil right there. Very cool design. And that is a giant hole, by the way. So here's a 2mm drill bit. It is well beyond the 2mm. Now a 3, it's bigger than a 3. So we're looking at like 3.2 maybe. I'm not going to measure it out for you. Let's see. Yeah, it's about 3.2mm. And what you've got here is two screws right here in the center. And those, I'm sorry, not in the center, on the outsides here. And those are what you attach your coils to. So this allows you to run it in a dual coil or a single coil fashion. Now, for me, trying to build on it, I'd rather do a single coil. So what I've gotten here right now is a 1.4 macro coil, a very large coil. And I broke it down for you guys. We cleaned it out. And what we're going to do is, we'll chat about it a little bit, we'll wick it, and we'll vape on it. So here's the outside, what it looks like. Veritas, nicely engraved in there. I don't think it came with this drip tip. I believe this was my Eagle M drip tip. Not positive. There's your air hole in the back. Again, this is a large air hole, but you can change it. So once you put it on your device, you just twist and turn based on how much airflow you want. To me, open is good. There's no reason not to have it open. Let's zoom in here. Focus. Maybe. Let's try something else. Awkward silence time. You gonna focus? There we go, we found focus. Okay, so as you guys can see, inside is a very deep juice well. Very cool, holds a ton of juice. It's fantastic. There's the nut on the top, which is where you're gonna be connecting one of your leads to. Very simple. I'll show you when we jump up close what it looks like. So, pros. This guy has a huge. Ooh, it's still sizzling. I got a little bit of water in there. A huge juice well. Very awesome. I enjoy the juice well. It's huge. It's fantastic. It has a very generous airflow with the giant 3.5mm or so, 3mm or so air hole in the back. Very easy to juice up. You can drop it down the drip tip. You can take it off and fill the juice wells. You can actually fill it through the air hole if you want, and it'll juice down. Other positive is it will very rarely leak, because once you put this on, the juice is stuck in that chamber. It would have to be significantly overfilled to fall down that hole and come back out. It would have to be significant. I mean, we're talking about you just drained your juice into there like a dumbass. I don't even know what word to use. What are the pros? If you're building a single coil, it is an easy build. However, as a con, if you're building a dual coil, kind of a pain in the ass. So we'll talk about that when we zoom up close. Another con, it's adjustable airflow, but it's not adjustable airflow. You just have that big hole, and yeah, you can turn a little bit, but it can be a pain in the ass. With any vertical coil that I've found, in my opinion, this is also a con, is when you wick it, you have a tendency to have the bottom of your juice well filled and your coils empty. Now, that's also a wicking error, obviously, on me. That can obviously be put on anybody who makes their own coils. However, I find that this happens with a lot of people, and it happens very consistently on vertical coils. And I understand why, because the coil is obviously sitting up way raised over the wick, and the wick's not going to feed it that much. So you have to be careful on the wicking system here. And we'll wick it down here, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Pop that up a little bit. Another, I don't know if it's really a con, but it's a wing nut on the top, which you have to hand screw and then probably take a pair of tweezers and twist it, which is kind of a pain in the ass. And I believe this guy does not have an adjustable 510. We'll double check. Not that it matters, again, because I'm an IPv2, so it doesn't care. So it's not adjustable 510. But again, doesn't matter to me because I'm on IPv2, but for you MechMod users, maybe a pain in the ass. You gotta, that whole flush thing you gotta do. Well, to build on it, to talk about it a little bit more, we're gonna need to jump down close. So let's do that now. Okay, so we're down here up in closey, and you can see again a little bit better view what it looks like. Real deep wells, this curved piece right here. Allows the juice, if you tilt it sideways, it's just going to come up this well right here. Two nice O-rings, which are going to hold this device in place. Another con that I didn't talk about is when you do have this juiced up, you put on your top cap and then you pull it off, you'll get, if you have any juice in there, it will go flying, because this is a tight little pull from these O-rings. It is what it is, not the end of the world. You can see a little water came up, me cleaning it right there. There's your adjustable airflow. Like I said, you could just pop your top cap on and then twist it to where you want. And that's all there is to it. Pretty basic. So we're going to grab some wick real quick. And we're going to wick this guy. And I'm going to show you at least how I do it. Whether it's the proper way, I couldn't tell you. But we're going to do it how I want to do it. Grab a fresh cotton ball. You're just looking at an IPv2 because I'm in the background grabbing a cotton ball. This is a macro coil, so we're going to take a good chunk of cotton out of here. Alright, drop cotton over there. Drop some cotton over here. To me, lately I've been finding that I like my cotton to be real tight in the coil. I feel like that just holds the juice better, in my opinion. I've been doing it that way for a while now, and it just seems to work for me, at least. Everybody's got their own thing, and that's kind of mine. Just gently roll it. I don't know if you people roll it like you do joints. I couldn't tell you. I've never done marijuana before. Let's see. What I'm going to do is... This is really hard on camera. And all I'm going to do is try to get a piece of it in there. And this is where it gets a little bit tricky. And what I'm going to do is take a syringe and just kind of push it through. Okay, and we've got a good chunk of it in there. And like most vertical coils, it can be a pain in the ass to wick. So what I'm going to do is just pull it through. And I think that's probably plenty. I'm going to trim off that piece. I'm going to trim off this piece. And I think we'll have plenty of wick that's going to fill that hole up real quick. If I can find scissors. There we go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to trim it off about here because it's pretty knotted. And then what I'm going to do is trim it off as high as I can here. Or I'm just going to pull on it and make a goddamn mess. Son of a bitch. Okay. So we got it wicked right here, and all I'm going to do is take my syringe and kind of drop it in that pool, that huge well that's down here. Big well, okay? Got a nice big well. And I like to take this piece and unblock the coil, so that way when the vapor comes up, it's not hitting this wick right here. So I'll take this wick and I'll just kind of push it off to the left, and that way when I drip, it'll kind of catch it, which is nice. Okay. So what we gotta do now is juice it. Man, what are we gonna juice it with? I think we're gonna do
I've got some Cloud Nine, which is absolutely delicious. Maybe we'll do some Cloud Nine. Out of Space Jam, which makes me sad. I'm in the Papa Roach mode. God, I can't speak today. Papa Roach mode. Mood. Mode. I don't know. Of a broken heart. Alright, let's see. So we got that nice... Oh, man, that smells delicious. Oh, for a dark vape, it's actually pretty light right now. He's only been steeping about 3 days, but boy, do they smell delicious. Alright, so we got it nice and saturated, nice and saturated. I'm gonna fire it. We've got vapors. Oh, God, it just smells absolutely delicious. It's just ridiculous how good it smells. We get a lot of juice in there, because we can get a lot of juice. We can get this guy really saturated. Okay, so what we're going to do is we got nice and juiced. What we're going to do is we're going to pop up top, vape on it. I'll give you my thoughts on it. Alright guys, we're back up top. We've juiced it. I showed you how I wick it. I didn't build on it only because I really like the build I have in here right now. It's treating me very, very well and I don't want to mess it up. Especially with vertical coils. I'm not the best vertical coiler in the world. Matter of fact, I built the Origin V2 and hated building the vertical coil so much it's still sitting there. I don't even want to look at it right now. I don't even want to look at it. So, when it came to the Veritas, I was going to be really scared. I was going to hate it. And it turned out okay. And the vape goes great, great with that beer. Absolutely fantastic. Now, oh, first, before I say no, we're going to play the Where's the Cap game. There it is. There we go. Found that game. All right, game over. So we got it back up top. Open airflow. We're just going to vape on it real quick. Delicious. So as you guys, God, I really cannot speak to this. This is a horrible day. As you guys can see, this is a single coil like I showed you up top. I think this device would go very well with a parallel coil. I would take a parallel coil, wrap it four or five times, get like a 1.0, 1.2 ohm, throw that dead set in the middle. Dead center in the middle of the air hole, which is where you want it, and it would be perfect if you're looking for that parallel dual coil build. To me, the single coil is perfect. This guy is really a flavor chaser. It's not going to blow huge clouds, so it does have quite a bit of airflow. It's very airy draw. This guy is a flavor chaser. Even with the air hole fully open to me with this huge wide bore drip tip on it, it still tastes fantastic. It's just delicious. It's not a super warm vape because I got it at about 23 watts on a single coil, but it's very, very good. I got a nice throat hit at 6 milligrams. It tastes delicious. So what do I think about it? I think it's fantastic. It's not the greatest build in the world. It's kind of a pain in the ass. Honestly, when it comes to vertical coils, if your coils aren't perfect, I just say fuck it, because at that point it's such a pain in the ass to build them that if they're in there and they turn red, we're good. We're good in business. So, personally, I think dual coil would be parallel coil, excuse me, would be perfect in this build. So, that's my opinion on that. Parallel coil would be awesome. Nice airy draw. You can close it off if you want. I personally like it like this. I don't want to close it off. Just like the Magma. I like to vape it sideways so that juice is flowing and it keeps filtering into the wick. Also, just like the Magma, I can take quite a few hits off this device before I have to rejuice it again, because that really deep juice well, when you drip it, it's falling not only into the top, but it's also filling all the juice well around, which is really, really cool. I really, really like this device. And it still has the ability to chuck some good clouds. I got like a tornado going in here from the fan. which is pretty cool. Overall, for $15-16, you can buy this on eBay. Two thumbs up. Fantastic little device. It looks just like the real one, which is what I really like about it. The emblem, the engraving is really, really nice. I don't think it came with a drip tip. But don't quote me on it. I don't see it up here. I don't think it did. So I threw my Ego M drip tip on it, and I absolutely love it. The build isn't the best in the world, in my opinion. Again, if you like vertical coils, you probably absolutely love it. But I don't, so it's not the best build in the world for me. However, once I got it in there and I got a nice, good build in there, I've had no complaints whatsoever. If you want to put dual coils in, you're going to have to put them in a smaller coil size. So that way you can make sure those two coils are lined up in front of the one air hole. And I just put up two numbers. One air hole. So that's why I didn't really build the dual coil system, and I thought the single coil would be much easier. So what you're going to do is just basically pop the screws up, wrap it once, tighten the screw down. It's like a K-Fun setup. It didn't try to squeeze the coil out or anything like that. It was pretty simple. Any other things I want to point out about it? That's really about it. It's very cool. It does have a small 510 connection pin on it, FYI. So it sits flush on my PP2, even though I really don't want it to. I don't like stuff sitting flush. So I like to back it off a little bit, just where it makes connection. Right there, boom. Delicious. Freaking delicious. That marshmallow and caramel, oh, it's so good. That's what I got for you. Real quick review. I'm sorry I didn't do a build for you, but I just love that coil too much. I can't take it out. I really enjoy it. So until next time, guys, LEGO PC. Peace.